Welcome to Acoustic Bulletin's Academy of Knowledge. Here we teach you about indoor acoustics or room acoustics, and we inspire to create good environments which resembles the outdoors, the nature. In this episode, we will take a close look at open plan office acoustics. If you look at this arrangement, this is a very common seating arrangement in an open plan office. People work in a team, they work together, they communicate. You see, they feel good, they can focus on the task, and they can perform to the highest level.
Yellow. Hi, Dave. Yeah. Just got into the office right now. Yeah, I'm talking to the people. I'm going to try and get the deal out of them. Yeah. No, I can meet you up for lunch in a few hours. Just let me, you know, kick back and do my work, and then I'll give you a call, and then we'll meet at lunch. All right. All right. Bye now.
This is a very common problem in an open plan office. Sound from such a telephone conversation can reach far in this space. And actually, the distance speech travel is what we call speech propagation. And this is what you need to take care of. Otherwise, sound levels will escalate and other people will start to raise their voices as well. And you will have a poor sound environment.
Well, no, let's just contact the firm and have them look at what they can do to solve the problem.
We'll give them a good offer.
I'm sorry.
We'll just call them up right
now. Could you repeat that?
We'll make sure the cooperation
works just as well as we want
it to. There's
a lot of noise in the office right now, and I can't really hear what you're saying.
So, how can we actually prevent this? Well, you need to know about the people in the office, what roles they have, and also the office space. For instance, the people that should work together should be able to communicate with each other. But you have to separate them from other people that need silence and concentration. Also the room, it may be so that you have hard surfaces which will actually add to the sound propagation. Now, what you need is a highly efficient sound absorbing ceiling as to positively contribute to reducing the spreading of sound and also an overall reduction of sound levels. And you also need wall absorbers because some of the sound energy will not actually reach up to the ceilings. And regarding wall panels, it is very good to have them at two adjacent walls. When we look at these people, it seems like they are not absolutely happy with this situation. We need something more. Now, what do we need to do? Not so difficult. We actually need a screen. A sound-absorbing screen. The same good acoustic properties as the ceilings and the wall panels. Now, with the screen, you actually create sound barriers in the room and you will reduce the overall sound propagation. The width of the screen should be able to match the desk and or the workstation, and the height of the screen should actually be, it should be high enough so that sound is not floating over it to the other side. Or just like water, sound can float over an obstacle. It may actually also be able to float under, and that's why the screen also need to be all the way down almost to the floor. So what about the placement of screens? Well, best is if you place the screen very close to the talker, to the sound source, or close to the receiver. But ideally is to put the screen close to both of them.
No, sir, I really respect your decision, but I still want you to go back and look
Come
at my
closer.
Proposal again, because my proposal is
Come
the
closer.
Best decision for
Listen.
The company right now.
Quite a difference, isn't it?
Sat down and talked this through, we would
well,
come to a much better deal.
Let's sum up here. The people, make sure that you know about the people and the tasks, and that you separate noisy people from the ones who need silence. And also, you need a sound-absorbing ceiling, having a very high articulation class value, as to be able to take care of speech propagation. You also need wall panels to make sure that you take care of the sound energy which is not coming up to the acoustic ceiling. And you need screens as acoustic barriers in the landscape. Now, our tests actually show that when you use the three elements in your open plan office, you have excellent acoustic conditions. So we could say like 2 plus 1 actually equals to more than 3. So thank you for watching this episode. And if you have any questions, do not hesitate to contact our concept developers. So see you next time. But remember, the sounds you should hear, you should actually hear clearly.